UK 53rd annual Lord's Passover.
53rd annual Lord's Passover is going to be held down here in Florida.
It's going down.
You're here tonight to get a chance to be righteous enough to be worthy of God coming to save you.
That's right.
It's going down. The Lord's 53rd annual Passover.
When we say we no cowards, we stop that business. We no cowards up in here.
Book your hotels now at the Holiday Inn Express and Suites, the IHG Hotel, 301 Tucker Lane, Cocoa Beach, Florida, 32926.
Y'all see this?
Touch with all your dishes, pots,
pans,
forks, knives.
I got to light this. This is like an apartment room. And a hotel room.
This here right here is about to be holy ground. It's going to be holy ground. All our beautiful, wonderful brothers and sisters from all over the world. You understand? We can boast that now. Brothers and sisters coming not only from this every state, but from all over the world. I heard the numbers this year is ridiculous. We had to buy out the whole hotel.
Friday, April 15th at the Space Coast Convention Center.
My camp undefeated. You cannot debate. You just want the clout. We just want the greats. I'm just trying to get it.
This is going to be glorious. Glory, glory, glory.
Shalom, DC. We're the Israelite School of Universal Practical Knowledge. We start out at 1 West 125th Street out of Harlem, New York, under command of Jenny Ahana. You understand? Just reiterating what the brother said. We're not affiliated with any Christian organization or any other Israelite organization, man. You understand? We stand with the Lord and we teach the truth according to the Bible to the 12 tribes on this chart right here, man. You understand? That's what we come out here to teach. And today, man, the brothers are already dropping the topics. We're going to go into the deception and all of the lies and what being in the Christian church, the spirit that it puts us in. What we fail to understand is our parents and our parents' parents and our parents' parents' parents learned what they thought was right and wrong from the Christian church, man. You understand? That's what we learned, what was right and wrong. You understand? However, we didn't learn what was wrong according to God in that Christian church. You understand? So we actually going to have to put the spirit of the Christian church on the podium, man. We're going to have to try the spirit by the spirit. You understand? Having the spirit and being a Christian allows us to not understand the actual spirit of God, man. And when we find out, and being a Christian, what we are taught is to hate God, man. And to hate Christ. And to hate what they stood for. You understand? And to worship ourselves. The spirit of Christianity is absolutely selfish, man. And it's destructive to blacks, natives, and Hispanics. You understand? Ask yourself one question. We all grew up in the Christian church. We all grew up with the Bible. You understand? But what has Christianity actually done for us as a whole? What has it done for us? Anybody raise their hand and say, what has it done? Has it stopped all of the black sisters going missing? Has it stopped the Latino sisters going missing? Has it stopped the suicide rate on the reservations? Has it stopped the hoods and the projects and all of the drama and gangbanging? Has it stopped us from murdering our babies? Has it stopped us from getting high? I think not. I think all of that still goes on here in 2022. You understand? The brother was bringing out earlier, he said that we are taught that it's all one nation. And now what does the Christian church teach us? It has us believe that we are one nation. You understand? That's why it's babble. That's why it's confusion, man. You understand? Because we are not a nation adjoined to our oppressor, man. You are too special, black man, Hispanic man, to be joined and to think that this devil is your brother, man. Because what have they shown you? We all know what a brother is. We all know what an A1 day one is. Well, tell me how our oppressor has been a brother to us. The Bible say, give me Ecclesiastes, give me to the book of Ecclesiastes, man. The Bible say that a gift destroyeth the heart, right? That's what the Bible says. And all our person has to do is slap us up and down the aisle, slap us up and down the road, shoot us, oppress us for 400 plus years, wage war against us, throw drugs in our neighborhood, throw guns in our neighborhood, and then give you a statue like Martin Luther King. And that's just supposed to make everything better. You understand? Didn't give you a Black History Month when black men, your history is longer than a month. Hispanic man and Native American Indian, your history is longer than a month. But of course, a gift disturbs the heart. It makes us docile, man. Forget the gift that America wants to give us, man. You understand? Listen, we got happy and jumped up and down, the water out of one. We got happy and jumped up and down when we heard that they might be putting Harriet Tubman on a $20 bill. And we said, thank you, Jesus, thank you, God. We done it again. Gold is straight. You understand? And we deserve way more than that, man. Come on. We done built all of their skyscrapers. We done been the reason for all of their entertainment. You understand? We're the reason why they won all of their wars. We're the reason why you have medical advancements. God will come. The least they can start with is by giving us some type of ownership. Or 25 states out of 50. But no, they don't do that. Nah, they don't do that. They give you a statue and say, hey, here you go. Mwah, take that. That's what they did. They give you Black History Month and say, mwah, take that. You understand? That's what they gave us, and the gift destroyed our heart. And you know who it allowed to destroy our heart? Having that Christian spirit. The Christian spirit allowed us to accept Black History Month, man. The Christian spirit allows what happens to us, and then we're told to forgive and love. We're not taught the truth of the Bible. Hey, God will come. The Christian spirit allowed us to get the Black anthem, man. You understand? Christianity is not Black supremacy, man. It's white supremacy. But the truth of this Bible is absolute Black supremacy. It's all up and down in it. The problem is our leaders failed to teach us it, man. The problem is we had a lot of cowards as well, man. You understand? Real Black leaders is right there in that Bible. You understand? Matter of fact, drop that. Give me Ecclesiastes 7:7, man. We're going to read it in the Bible, man. 7:7. You understand? Having that spirit and being in that Christian church has done nothing for us. Our children got molested in there. We still got evicted when service was over. Our cars still got repoed when service was over. Our lights still shut off when service was over, man. Our water still shut off when service was over. The Christian church ain't done nothing for us, man. Listen, you still molested when service over. You think 9 o'clock, 10 o'clock, 11 o'clock is over. You ain't got to get touched no more. Wrong. Take it to the back of the church. Right. You understand? These wicked behind pastors, man. And this religion is not for us, man. You got that scripture? Read.
This is the book of Ecclesiastes. Chapter 7, verse 7. Surely, oppression maketh a wise man mad.
You understand? The Bible says surely, man, without a doubt. Oppression is going to make a wise man mad. But what do we do? We shouting up and down and having a good time in this slavery, man. You understand? We enjoying the so-called luxuries we get here in America. You got to be kidding me, man. It says surely a wise man, you understand? He feels oppressed. He knows oppression. He sees his community is on the down. You understand? He sees all of the bloodshed. That's a wise man. You understand? To see that and not ignore that. To not want to join the people as such. That's a wise man. A wise man that understands oppression. Keep reading.
Oh, God. And a gift destroyeth the heart.
And a gift destroyeth the heart, man. And that's exactly what happened, man. Christianity was a gift to Blacks and Hispanics. And it destroyed our hearts, man. You understand? This white devil, this oppressor right here with the blue eyes, man. You understand? Has oppressed our community for I don't know how many years, man, and how many generations, man. We've been lied to and fed this image right here, and we don't understand just how destructive it is. We don't understand how destructive it is to slap a people up and down the road, beat them, enslave them, set dogs on them and set them on fire, and then turn them around and turn Christ, the greatest man ever walked the face of this earth, and say that he's a Caucasian. When the Bible says otherwise, man. Keep reading.
Come on.
Read from the top.
This is the book of Ecclesiastes. Chapter 7, verse 7.
Go ahead.
Surely oppression maketh a wise man mad. And a gift destroyeth the heart.
Y'all have to understand this how listen, man, up in here we let you know that Christianity is the worst drug. Compared to heroin and crack, Christianity is the worst drug that's ever been put on Black students in the Hispanics.
Right.
Because Christianity, the spirit of being a Christian, doesn't allow blacks and Hispanics to want justice, man. It allows us to get slapped up and down, milkshakes put on our head, and just accept it, man. And be the bigger man. You want to be the bigger man? You come getting this truth, man. What are you talking about? Damn right. You understand? Mostly drugs destroy your body. But Christianity, that destroys your body and your mind, man.
Right.
Or that thing destroys your soul, man. You understand? The water. The brother brought it out earlier again. Talk about all we hear is love, 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 love. And there's never a time to hate. Having the spirit of a Christian, you never get the chance to hate. You're wrong for hating evil. You're wrong for looking at what's going on with your people. And you look at it like you're crazy. I know we look like a bunch of crazy black men up here. And according to our society we live in, we're wrong for it. We wrong? You mean to tell me we're wrong for not wanting black sisters and Latino sisters getting raped and going missing? We wrong for that. A little white girl go missing, they get Amber Alert. What an Amber Alert for the black stays in the Spanish, huh? What an Amber Alert for them? But we don't get that. You understand? The world stops. You would have thought the earth stopped moving, boy. You understand? You would have thought the earth stopped moving when a little white girl goes missing. But let a little black girl go missing. She'll turn up. They don't even take it serious at the precinct, man. They don't even give it 72 hours. Anybody know the time? They say give it 48, 72 hours. They just probably had to pop. You understand? But the wrong gift destroyed our heart. We ain't get no Amber Alert. Ain't no black millionaire came out with some app to find out where the black sister's at, where the Latino sister's at. But we sure as hell accepted that Martin Luther King statue and Black History Month. We accepted those things. But what did that do for us? Can anybody tell me? I don't think the cricket sitting over there in the corner can tell me, man. You understand? Drop that, give me James 4 and 4. You understand? The Bible tells us to try the spirit by the spirit. And we're going to bring that out as well. The problem with having that Christian spirit is we don't try spirits at all. Or we accept it. We don't know the spirit of Valentine's Day like the brothers is breaking down. We don't know that that's evil against God. You understand? We don't try the spirit of the Christian church. Being Christian allows us to accept the philosophy of our oppressor and not what the Bible actually says. You understand? That's what it allows us to accept. It makes us blind. It disables all of our senses. You understand?
And that spirit really, really is destructive. It's far worse than a nuclear explosion. I know an old cat like me remember the early 90s, late 80s when crack hit our neighborhood left and right. I remember those days. You had crack dealers selling to your own mama. If you was some of those would even sell to their own family members, you know what I'm saying? Left and right, everywhere, you know what I'm saying? In the meantime, the Christian leaders did nothing at all. They let it happen. You know what I'm saying? Only when it affected their house immediately is when they ever said anything. Meanwhile, the colonizer put them drugs in our neighborhood. The colonizers put guns in our neighborhoods because their goal and their aim is to always destroy black and brown people. To this day, because of Christianity, once upon a time, Chocolate City was known because of all the black folks everywhere. Now, where the black folks at in D.C.? Homeless, with no place to go. Properties that were once owned by black folks, where are they now? And then they put the prices so high, you can never buy those properties back.
Right.
I'm going to tell you something. Christianity is so deadly for Latinos as well. Because right now in Puerto Rico, right, they passed the law 20 and 22, right? Which means this, to put it in a nutshell, in Puerto Rico, if you got some green, right, and you're gringo, you can go to Puerto Rico, set up shop, and never have to pay for capital gains tax at all. And then on top of that, they're going to put a big statue, as tall as the Statue of Liberty, of Columbus in Puerto Rico, all right? And then if you look at the Statue of Columbus from a distance, it looks like it's got a middle finger up, saying to all your brothers, the Taino Indians, to the Dominicans that live on the island, to the Cubans, like, F every last one of you. Like, the colonizer never ceases to stop colonizing. Like, he likes to gobble, he likes to take everything. In his mind, manifest destiny is the way of life. And if you're black and brown, it don't matter.
Right.
And then in the meantime, us Puerto Ricans, We for a long time tried to love the righteous. Can I get that image right there, Moses? Hey, can I get that image? Hey, come on. All right. In the meantime, just like every other Latino, black man, West Indian man, we love this guy so much. Like, you can't tell us nothing, even to this day, Latinos that are in Christian church love this guy. But this is the devil that the Bible speaks of. ¿Entiende, hermanita? Este es el diablo con cuerno, lo que dice la Biblia. Este rubio que servimos en la iglesia es el diablo con cuerno, lo que dice la Biblia. According to the Bible, this is the devil. And you can see it's a representation of our colonizer. Right now, you go to Puerto Rico. Once upon a time, our public beaches, any Boricua, any black man that come from the mainland, go to Puerto Rico and enjoy the beautiful sights. Puerto Rico, like many of the islands in the Caribbean, is got beautiful panoramic views, so much so they make you want to stay over there. But these devils move into our land, move into our coastal areas, and then won't allow us on our own public beaches to have a good time. We've been doing that for generations, but they come with like their parents and Kevins that they are. This is private. Private according to who? Huh? Meanwhile, the Boricuas, we gotta suffer that. We gotta take that as an L. But carajo todo esto, we ain't gonna do that no more. That's what we're gonna do is start smoking weed. That's what we're gonna do. Right. We're gonna start smoking crack is what we're gonna do. Right. And we're gonna tell Christianity, get the hell out of the island. Right. Get the hell away from us. No longer we're gonna serve your white Jesus. Because this has been the destruction of every black and Hispanic and Native American Indian to this day. This right here in far west. Este es peor droga en la faz de la tierra. This is the worst kind of drug ever to be put in the black and brown community. This right here served us no good.
Shalom, Israel. It's that time again. The week of Passover is packed with exciting events hosted by the ISUPK and Commanding General Yohanan. On Tuesday, a deep sea fishing trip with the generals. Arrival and boarding time at 7:30 a.m. The boat leaves at 8 a.m. sharp. Then on Wednesday, April 13th, join us for the annual lamb slaughter from 12 p.m. to 3 p.m., making sure the children of Israel have fresh lamb for the Passover. Then, after that, the ISUPK is having a fish fry from 4 p.m. until, which will lead to the scripture breakdown class with General Mahaima. Then, on Thursday morning, Hebrew Academy participants will see if they have what it takes to endure the Hebrew Academy trials. Commanding General Yohana has something special lined up for the children with a children's party from 10:30 a.m. to 1:30 p.m. Come join Commanding General Yohana on Cocoa Beach as we renew our oath unto the Lord.
Because he spoke to understand the power of the Most High, death wouldn't destroy him, and we'll destroy him. Real soon. Read. That assuredly, knowing unto what oath they had given credence, they might afterward be of good cheer. You hear that? They was of good cheer. Came an oath with the Lord as one. And became of good cheer while tens of thousands of Egyptians died. I know y'all don't like to talk about this, but you better put this war spirit back in you, Israel. You better get that spirit back in you, man. You better get that spirit of warfare back in you, because the Lord will put blood on the streets of America and around this world, brother.
Followed by a hotel ballroom, all black and Hebrew Academy dinner from 9 p.m. to 1 a.m. And then, on Friday, April 15th, at 5 p.m., join us for the Lord's annual Passover, as commanded in the scriptures. At 5 p.m. sharp. On Saturday, April 16th, the Feast of Unleavened Bread. That's right, we're going to keep the Feast of Unleavened Bread from 7 p.m. to 10 p.m. Commanding General Yohana has it all lined up for you, Israel. Come keep the Lord's Passover. Shalom.